رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم used to have a young man who stand by his door at night only in case رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم woke up and needed any help. ربيعة wanted to be there and serve رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he was a very young man, they say 11, 12 years old. So one time رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he came out and he told ربيعة, or he asked ربيعة a question that every Muslim dream about. He said, Ya Rabi'a, ask me, Ya Rabi'a, what do you want? So many narrations, and answer of Rabi'a was, Ya Rasulullah, I want your company in Jannah. I want to be with you in Jannah. And he did not say, I just want Jannah. I want a horse, I want a house, I want a wife. I want your company in Jannah. So what did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell him? A'inni ala nafsika bikathrati sujood. If you want that goal, like we say here, in America, help me help you. If you want that goal of being with me in Jannah, help yourself by performing a lot of sujood. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam named the salat sujood. He's not telling Rabi'a make a lot of sujood. Here he's telling them make a lot of salat. So the sujood, which was our talk tonight, it was the salat is called sujood. This is how important it is. And Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, sir, the secret of salat is in sujood. And he said, all the things we did before sujood are preparation for sujood. And it's so good that we do it twice. What are the du'as that Rasulullah ﷺ taught us in the sujood? Like we said before, there are du'as that are common between ruku' and sujood. And there are du'as that are strictly for ruku' and there are du'as that are strictly for sujood. Last time we took the du'as for ruku'. The ones that are common, we said them before, Subhanak Allahumma Rabbana wa bihamdik, Allahumma ghfirli. This is in Bukhari. Rasulullah used to say this in ruku' and in sujood. Subbuhun quddusun rabbul malaikati wal ruh. In ruku' in sujood. Subhan Rabbi al-Azim, strictly ruku'. Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, strictly sujood. And we mentioned few that are strictly in ruku' and today we mentioned two only that Rasulullah ﷺ taught us to say in sujood. Subhanallah. First, before we mention those two du'as, we want to remember, ya akhwan, that the closest me and you are to Allah when we are in sujood. So Rasulullah ﷺ said, when you are in that position, is'al. Ask whatever you want. Allah Azza wa Jal himself said, Fasjud waqtarib. The more you make sujood, the closer you are to me, to Allah Azza wa Jal. Last ayah in Surah Al-Alaq. Make sujood and come close. The more you make sujood, yani salat, the closer you are to Allah Azza wa Jal. So when we are in sujood, make any dua, ya akhi. Any dua. So what are the two du'as we will take today, inshallah ta'ala? Number one, Rasulullah s.a.w. said, he used to say in his sujood, Allahumma ghfir li dhanbi kullah, diqqahu wa jillah, awwalahu wa akhirah, alaniyatahu wa sirrah. Ya Allah, forgive all my sins, the small ones and the big ones, the first ones and the last ones, the ones I did in secret and the ones I did in public. يعني there's no more sins left. All kinds of sins. Ya Allah, forgive them all. That's the first one. Second one, Sahih Muslim. Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, I used to hear Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say this dua in his sujood. Allahumma laka sajad, wa bika amant, wa laka aslamt, sajada wajhi, lilladhi khalaqahu wa sawwara, wa shakka sam'ahu wa basara, fatabaraka Allah, ahsanul khaliqin. Beautiful dua. Ya Allah, to you I'm making sujood. And Ya Allah, I believe in you. And Ya Allah, I submit to you. Sajada wajhi. My wajh, my face made sujood to the one who created it and fashioned it. And the one who gave it hearing and vision. Fatabaraka Allah, ahsanul khaliqin. Glorified Allah, the best of creators. Subhanallah. Sujood is the only ibadah, is the only thing that the more you descend, the more you are elevated.